मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस लेक्चर, अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन, चैप्टर नंबर 8. सो वी हैव डिस्कस द लिटरल्स, नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरिएबल्स. अ सिंबल व्हिच टेक्स ऑन वेरियस न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यूज, मींस वी हैव डिस्कस दैट टू टाइप्स ऑफ सिंबल. वन टाइप ऑफ सिंबल इज फिक्स्ड वैल्यू, लाइक आवर नंबर्स आर हैविंग फिक्स्ड वैल्यू, एंड अनदर वन इज लिटरल्स, वी आर यूजिंग एज फॉर गेसिंग द वैल्यूज और फॉर द अननोन वैल्यूज और some such type of values. So alphabets are basically variables which take the different values. Like I have written x. So sometimes x have the value 3. In some cases x have the value 4. In some cases x have the value 12. Like that. But in the case of 1, 1 is always 1. 2 is always 2. It cannot be changed. Means these are the fixed values and these are the symbols which having different numerical values or various numerical values. Okay. So that it is called variables. Variables we can use alphabets or any other symbols other than numbers. Means other than numbers, we can use the different symbols for initializing the variables. Okay. Next is constants. Constants are those symbols who are having fixed numerical values, like our numbers. Our numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. These are the symbols which have fixed numerical values. These are the symbols which are fixed numerical values. So we cannot change the value of 2. It is always 2. But it cannot be 3, 4, 5, etc. 2 is always 2. 3 is always 3. 4 is always 3. Just like that. So these are called constants. Okay. Now. So first we need to identify how many constants and how many variables are there. Okay. So here, check, this is a variable, this is a variable, and this is a constant. So how many variables? Variables are 2 and constants are 1. Okay. So in this manner we are going to find how many constants and how many variables are there. Okay, one more thing. If let me take x plus 7y minus 12. Like that is given. So we do not consider these as a constant because they are the multipliers of the variable. So we cannot consider it as a constant. Constant is only considered when no variable is attached with the value. When no variable is attached with the value, then it is constant, considered as a constant. So this one is variable, this one is variable. So we can say that only two variables are there, 2, and constants are 1. Okay. In this manner we are going to find how many variables and how many constants are there. Next thing is algebraic expression. Algebraic expression. Algebraic expression. It is a combination of variables and constant with the operators. Operators means basic arithmetical operator, plus, minus, multiplication and division. These are the basic mathematical operators. Like that I have given x plus 7 minus y. This is the algebraic expression because it is a combination of constant, variable and operators. These are the two operators and this is constant, this variable and this is variable. So if the combination of variable constant are there, so we can say that it is an algebraic expression. Okay. So this is the algebraic expression. Now next thing is this. Suppose one algebraic expression is given, 7x plus y minus 12, this is given. So there are one more thing, that is term. How we identify the term is separated by the operators. This is the operator, so this is one term, this is another term, and this is another term. Either it will be a constant or variable, but it is called a term is separated by the operators. In terms operators, only two operators are considered, plus or minus. मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन आर नॉट कंसिडर्ड एज अ टर्म सेपरेटर्स. दीज टू आर नॉट कंसिडर्ड एज अ टर्म सेपरेटर्स. हियर 7 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई एक्स, बट वी आर कंसिडरिंग इट एज अ वन टर्म. हियर वाई इज सिंगल वन टर्म. हियर इज कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यू. दिस इज वन टर्म. टर्म्स बेसिकली आर सेपरेटेड बाय द ऑपरेटर्स. विच आर टू ऑपरेटर्स? एडिशन एंड सेपरेटर. दीज आर टू ऑपरेटर्स दैट इज दैट सेपरेट द टर्म्स. इन द बेसिस ऑफ टर्म वी कैन कैटेगराइज द अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन इन फाइव टाइप्स. ओके, नाउ टाइप्स ऑफ अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन. सो फर्स्ट टाइप इज मोनोमियल. मोनोमियल इफ एन अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन, इफ एन अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन, अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन हैविंग ओनली वन टर्म, आइदर इट बी अ वेरिएबल और कॉन्स्टेंट, that doesn't matter. So an algebraic expression having only one term, that is called monomial. Like I have written x or 7y or 3 or 12, these all are monomial. In this is a single term, no operator is there. This is a single term because 7 multiplied by we consider as a one term. Multiplication and division are not a term separator, so we consider it as a single term. This is also one term because it is a constant term, so variable and constant are also considered. So that these are the monomials. Monomials means the expression having exactly one term. Okay. Now next thing. Binomial. An expression having exactly two terms. An expression having exactly two terms, like x plus 3, or you can say 7y minus 12, or you can say zy 3 plus 2. Here multiplication product is there, but it's considered as a one term, and this is another term. Here z by 3 means division of z. Division of a variable is given, but it is considered as a one term because multiplication, product and the division quotient are not considered as a term separators. Only plus and minus are considered as a term separators. So these are the examples of binomial. Binomial, bi suggest means two. Bi means two. Bi suggest means two. Okay. Now next thing is trinomial. Next thing is trinomial. Trinomial. Tri suggest means three. Tri means three. An expression having exactly three terms. Exactly three terms. Like that, x plus 7y minus 12. Or you can say x by 3 plus 12y minus z. These are the examples of trinomial because it has exactly three terms. It has exactly three terms. This is one term, this is another, this is another. This one, two, three. Three terms are there, so this is called trinomials. Means expression having exactly three terms. Not more than three or not more, less than three. Okay? Exactly three terms. Okay? Next thing. Next thing. Quadrinomial. Quadrinomial. An expression having exactly four terms. Exactly four terms, like a plus b minus c plus d. This is four terms. 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. So it is called a quadrinomial. It has 4 terms like a by 2 plus b by 3 minus 7c plus 12. It has also 4 terms, so it is called a quadrinomial. Quadrinomial means, quad means 4, quad, like quadrilateral, quad means 4. Quad represents the value 4. So it has exactly 4 terms, so we can say that it is a quadrinomial. When the expression is having exactly 4 terms, then we will call it as a quadrinomial. Next is most important type. Most important type is polynomial. Polynomial. Next important type is polynomial. Polynomial. An expression having two or more terms. Means when the expression is having two or more terms, then it is called polynomial. Two or more terms, then it is called polynomial. Like I have written x plus 3, or I have written 7y minus 3 plus z, or I have written 7y 3x plus 12y plus z plus 7d. So these all are polynomial, means starting from two terms all are polynomials. So here two terms are there, it is a polynomial. Three terms means two or more, so it is more than two, it is also a polynomial. It is four terms means more than two, it is also a polynomial. So what I have to say, that what we have get here, that binomial is also polynomial because it has two terms, it is a polynomial, but it is also a polynomial. Trinomial is also a polynomial and quadrinomial is also a polynomial. After that, if an expression is having 5 terms, 6 terms, 7 terms, 8 terms, all are called polynomials. Starting from 2 terms, all are called polynomials. But we have some special type, like exactly 2 terms, then it is binomial. Exactly 3, then it is trinomial. Exactly 4, then it is called quadrinomial. But these all are, except monomial, are also polynomial. If you have to write, you can also if two terms is given, you can also write binomial or polynomial both, okay, or any one of them. If three terms is given, you can write trinomial or polynomial as you wish, okay. If four terms are there, you can write quadrinomial or polynomial. But see the question, what question is asking. Either it is asking for the particular separation or it is asking general separation. If general separation is given, then you can easily write the polynomial. Okay, so that's it for this particular lecture. We will continue next lecture. Thank you.